Good afternoon. I'd like to welcome everybody to this pep talk this afternoon. Please mute yourself, but always show your video picture. Sign in your name, your Facebook account, or email address in the chat box. Please include the names of companions attending with you. Use the chat box to ask questions and make comments while the pep talk is on. There will be group pictures at the start and end of the pep talk, so please show your faces in the video. A reminder after the pep talk is to take the online learning CUM evaluation test exercise for mastery of learning and have a perfect score to get a certificate like the one shown here. I have placed the link in the chat box. Obtaining 25 OLETE certificates starting 2024 will entitle one mentee to a voucher for a RO Hoson medical consultation, either face-to-face or telemedical. Another request, please type in your feedback in the chat box during the open forum and before we adjourn. Thank you. Let's now have a group picture taking before we start the pep talk proper in 2 minutes. Please show your faces in the video. One, two, I have a patient empowerment program in which I'd like to empower the lay people or patients to take control in the management of their health. I started the pep talk on May 15, 2021 during the COVID-19 pandemic. There are three courses in the pep talk. I already completed the core course on October 9, 2021. And then from October 23, 2021 onwards, I've been tackling health disorder and health issue courses. May 18, 2024 marks the start of year 4 of RO Hoson pep talk. How long the pep talk will last will depend on our enthusiasm, discipline, and perseverance. My pep talk today is entitled Thyroid, When do you need lab tests? The empowerment objective is for the lay people to have an essential understanding on thyroid, when do you need lab tests as part of their health management. The contents of this pep talk this afternoon will be: what is the thyroid? What is the thyroid gland? Where is the thyroid gland located? What is the anatomy of the thyroid gland? What are the diseases that may occur in the thyroid gland? What are lab tests for thyroid, which will be the focus for today's discussion? When do you need lab tests for thyroid? And when do you not have to do lab tests for thyroid? A disclaimer is that this pep talk will contain my thoughts, perceptions, opinions, and recommendations called from my personal experiences as from the writings of other health professionals. The thyroid gland is a gland. When you say gland, it produces hormones. So the thyroid gland is a gland that produces thyroid hormones. That's the name of the hormones, thyroid hormones, that circulate in the blood and whose functions are to mainly regulate body metabolism and promote growth and development of the body. So it's a gland that secretes two thyroid hormones, namely T4 and T3, into the bloodstream, which are then carried out throughout the body to function to regulate body metabolism and to promote growth and development of the human body. The thyroid gland is located on the front and central neck or central part of the neck here as illustrated. Normally, there are two lobes, the right and the left lobe. Most of the time, there are two. In some instances, you only have one lobe. And then these two lobes are connected with a structure which we call the isthmus. Yung sa gitna rito, connecting the right and the left lobe. So the right and left lobe, okay, the trachea is behind it. Okay. So the thyroid gland hug the trachea. Okay. A general term for the disorder of the thyroid gland is called goiter. This is the general term. Pag sinabing may goiter, may problema sa thyroid gland. So a goiter is an abnormality in the thyroid gland. It is a disease in the thyroid gland. So when you say goiter, it's a disease of the thyroid gland. It's an abnormality. It's a disorder of the thyroid gland. But the goiter is not just one abnormality or disease. There are so many different kinds of abnormalities or diseases affecting the thyroid gland. Thus, there are so many kinds of goiter. The abnormality in the goiter can be in terms of functions and anatomical structures. When you say functions, I say thyroid hormones, a thyroid gland that produces hormones, so that's their functions, and then it regulates the body metabolism and controls the development and growth of the human body. That's part of the functions of the thyroid gland. When you say anatomical structure, yung korte, yung structure ng thyroid gland. Okay. So let's start first with the in terms of functions. Kasi nagproproduce ng thyroid hormones. So the abnormality can either be sobra or kulang. So if it's the thyroid gland, if it's producing excessive amount of thyroid hormones, then we call the goiter is called a hyperthyroidism. Hyper means sobra. Okay. But if it's producing deficient or kulang the amount of thyroid hormones, then we call it hypothyroidism. So these two are two types of goiter, and then the problem there is the functions, abnormality in the functions. One is hyper, sobra ang hormones, hypo, kulang naman. So in terms of anatomical structure, yung korte ng thyroid gland, the two lobes and then connected with an isthmus, the abnormality is basically a mass or masses. So usually, pag mayroong bukol, then we call it the problem in the anatomical structures. And this mass or masses can either be cancer or not cancer, or benign. Okay? So pag may bukol, ang pinag-usapan palagi, whether it's cancer or not. The usual starting point in suspecting the presence of goiter is through palpation of the neck. Kinakapaing leeg. No? So normally, the thyroid gland is not palpable or impalpable, which means it cannot be palpated. Although it's there, but it cannot be palpated. It's not palpable. The exception is when you have very thin persons with thin soft tissue over the neck. Kaya nakakapa yung thyroid gland kung payat na payat yung tao. No? But ordinarily, kung medyo normal weight yung pasyente, no? Usually, if the thyroid gland is not palpable, we call it normal. It's there, but it's not palpable. No? If it's palpable, and then you start thinking of a goiter already. So if the thyroid gland is palpable, a goiter is said to be present. So once the thyroid gland is palpable, then you determine whether it is diffuse or nodular. Okay. Then later on, we determine what specific disease may be present. If it's, this is an illustration of a diffuse goiter. So ito yung medyo pale area, no, represent the normal thyroid gland, which is usually not palpable, two lobes, the isthmus. And then, pag lumaki ito, enlarged, kabilaan, right and left, then we call that diffuse goiter. Diffuse means generalized enlargement of the thyroid gland, diffuse goiter. May implication nito sa diagnosis Okay, when we say diffuse versus nodular. So nodular goiter naman, may mga bukol-bukol. Okay? This is a problem in structure of the thyroid gland. So it can be either one bukol, one nodule, or several or multiple nodules. Again, there's an implication here. No? So if the thyroid gland is diffuse, kung diffuse siya, usually we don't suspect cancer. Okay. It's only in nodular goiter that we suspect cancer. So instead, when it's diffuse goiter, we think about hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism. So although a diffuse goiter can be associated with euthyroidism, normal amount of thyroid hormones, there are instances meron siyang diffuse goiter, pero yung production of thyroid hormones still normal. So we call that euthyroidism. In hyperthyroidism, as mentioned, the thyroid gland is diffusely enlarged and excessive amount of thyroid hormones is being produced. In hypo naman, it's also enlarged. Okay? Or kadalasan, hindi rin mo makakapa, but it's the hormones being produced are very, very deficient. Kulang ng amount. Yeah, we call it hypothyroidism. If the goiter is nodular, may mga bukol-bukol, then thyroid cancer is always a suspect or a consideration in the diagnosis. Pag may nodules siya, mag-umpisa na tayo mag-iisip, cancer ba ito o hindi? Pag diffuse naman, ang pinag-uusapan, ito ba hypothyroid or hyperthyroid? Na? So, a thyroid cancer is not so common, fortunately, as benign thyroid nodules are more common in the ratio of 20 to 20 or some even 90 to 10. In some countries, in the Philippines, ganun din, 90 to 10. Na? So, mas common yung benign nodules versus cancer nodules. So, what are the lab tests for thyroid? So, this will be the focus of discussion this afternoon. When you say lab test, it means laboratory test. Yung ginagawa dun sa not physical exam. Physical exam is also a diagnostic test. Lab tests are diagnostic tests done in the laboratory centers. Lab tests are diagnostic procedures done in the laboratory setting or in a setting with equipment and special instruments, usually in the clinic, usually in isang office, isang department. So to differentiate it from the physical examination being done by physician in which this is also diagnostic in purpose. Pag na-examine ng isang doktor yung leeg ng pasyente, he is trying to diagnose what's the problem. So diagnosis. Pag may pinagawa ng test dun sa laboratory, ganun din. Okay, the attempt, the purpose is for diagnosis. Examples of lab tests will be the following. Thyroid function test, the T4, examining the T4 hormones, and F stands for free T4, and then thyroid stimulating hormones. So these are blood tests. And then the other type of laboratory diagnostic test will be the ultrasound, CT scan, MRI, nuclear scan, and PET scan. So these are called imaging tests, imaging procedures. Yung sa FT4, sometimes they put the FT3, very commonly done. FT4, FT3, TSH. These are some examples of blood tests to contrast it with imaging tests, which include ultrasound, CT scan, MRI, nuclear scan, PET scan. So when do you need lab tests? Lab tests are done only when indicated. Kung kailangan lang, hindi naman routine. So not all persons should have lab tests for thyroid. So indications for lab tests will be the following. When a physician is not certain of the clinical diagnosis, when you say clinical diagnosis, it's a diagnosis gotten from interviewing the patients for symptoms, anong nararamdaman niya, and then signs, yung mga data that's gotten from the physical examination by the physician. So clinical diagnosis is derived after interviewing the patient and then after palpating the patient's neck and also the other parts of the body. Okay. So that's clinical diagnosis. After the clinical diagnosis, kung hindi sigurado yung doctor as to the diagnosis, then he can do lab tests. And then medyo, kung medyo sigurado niya, pero he needs to confirm or be more certain of the clinical diagnosis because this would affect the type of treatment to be done, then he will do it. So these are the two indications for a lab test. Number one, as a rule, kung di kasi, kung di sigurado sa clinical diagnosis, gagawin. Number two, kung kailangan i-confirm, you want to be more certain, sabi natin, gusto niya maging 99% certain yan ang diagnosis because the treatment probably will need more radical procedures like operations, then gagawa siya ng extra, gagawa siya ng laboratory diagnostic test. So, lab tests when done should have a clinical diagnosis first. I just want to emphasize that. A physician determines whether a lab test is needed or not. I want to emphasize this because a lot of times, we see a lot of doctors not doing physical diagnosis, no? Clinical exam, diretso na sa lab test, and also patients, lay people, they go to the laboratory centers and then order and ask for lab tests without having a physical examination done by a physician first. Before the lab tests are considered, using the principles of patient empowerment, the following must be done. So, patient empowerment. No? So, number one, the patient should by himself or herself should know how to examine his own or her neck. So, if she knows how to examine her neck or his neck, he will end up with his findings. No suspicion for goiter, so no lab test is needed. So, papapain yung leg ng sarili ng pasyente, kung walang goiter, pwedeng wala ng lab test. But if there is uncertain of the findings, then the first thing is to consult a physician and not go to the laboratory and ask for a T3, T4, or ultrasound right away. So number two step will be consulting a physician, and the physician should be doing a physical examination of the neck. Okay, and then he will end up with no suspicion of goiter, wala siyang nakakapa, okay, wala namang symptoms of goiter, then no laboratory tests are needed. Now, if parang meron siyang doubt as to the presence or absence of goiter or as to the type of the goiter present, then he might do laboratory examination. It's either he is uncertain or he need to be more certain, then he will order for lab test. So before the lab tests are considered, using the principles of patient empowerment, again, the following must be done. Okay. Self-examination of the thyroid and neck first before considering the lab test. Huwag lulundag kagad sa lab test, okay, without doing a self-exam. So you have to learn how to do self-exam of the thyroid and the neck. Lab tests may not be needed after all. So I want to emphasize that to do a self-examination to check if any of this abnormality is present. Okay. I have discussed this. The abnormality comes in two forms, functional and structural. Functional, whether it's diffuse, whether it's hypo or hyper, or kung structural abnormality, kung may mga bukol, baka enlarge siya, yung structure can also malaking thyroid gland niya, diffusely enlarged, and kung may mga bukol-bukol, so pinag-usapan nito whether it's cancer, there mga bukol, whether they're cancer or not. Two essential things to do in self-examination for possible goiter. So you do a neck self-examination, which include the thyroid and the side of sa tabi ng neck, sa lateral side. Okay. And then you feel, try also to feel, ito, symptoms ito, you feel for goiter symptomatology, meaning you feel for symptoms that may suggest abnormality in the thyroid gland, especially in the functional ones, if they have symptoms of hyperthyroidism or hypothyroidism. So examples of symptoms of hyperthyroidism, yung palaging mabilis, may palpitation, malakas yung may sudden weight loss, ganun, ganun. And then hypothyroidism, palaging nanghihina, ganun. Okay, so those are the symptoms that you may have to monitor. Okay. So start with neck self-examination. Neck self-examination usually facilitates diagnosis and recognition of goiter in just 1 minute. Okay. Sandali lang yan if you know how to do it. So this is an illustration of self-examination for goiter. Stand in front of a mirror. Extend the neck, slightly pointing the chin towards the ceiling. And then take a sip of water before you swallow. Okay? Because swallowing will facilitate palpating the thyroid gland. Yung thyroid gland, nakakapa, you can feel that it moves up and down with swallowing. No? So kung nakakapa yung thyroid, then you try to determine whether it is an enlargement or may mga bukol-bukol. Another illustration here, how to palpate the thyroid gland using either one hand or two hands, pwede. Just hug the windpipe, the trachea, okay, firmly, and then swallow. And then try to determine kung may nag-glide na substance between the trachea and the finger, which is usually the thyroid gland. So during the palpation, ito yung i-determine kung meron kang goiter. You have a goiter if it's enlarged, okay? Ito yung normal size, hindi nakakapa, pero malaki siya, kabilaan, we call that diffuse goiter. And then the other thing to determine whether there are nodule, one single nodule or multiple nodules. So if you have these two conditions, diffuse goiter, nodules, then you say you conclude that you have a goiter. So you examine also the side of the neck, okay, for possible lymph node enlargement. Kasi yung mga lymph nodes could be a sign of thyroid cancer kung meron. Especially kung may bukol dyan sa thyroid gland mo, patapos may kulani sa side, no, ng neck, then we suspect cancer, thyroid cancer already. Thyroid cancer is also a kind of goiter. So other findings that will make one suspect the presence of thyroid cancer will be the following. You have a thyroid nodule or nodules that are hard, matigas na matigas. When you say matigas, ang feel noon is parang buto, yung tigas ng buto, or the thyroid nodule is or are fixed, hindi siya gumagalaw. Okay? So then you also suspect thyroid cancer. And if there are palpable lymph nodes on the side of the neck, you also suspect thyroid cancer. If there is a distant mass means malayo dun sa neck, no? Sa leeg. Kung meron kang bukol sa scalp, sa other parts of the body, okay, then we suspect a distant metastasis. When you say distant, when you have suspect distant metastasis, you're suspecting thyroid cancer. So any one of these signs, heart consistency, fixed lymph nodes, distant mass, would be enough to suspect thyroid cancer with a high degree of certainty. So aside from doing the neck self-examination, if goiter is present, okay, check if you have symptoms that may suggest abnormality in the thyroid gland, especially the functional ones, as I said, whether you have hyper or hypo. So check if you have sudden weight loss despite good appetite, then you start suspecting hyperthyroidism. If it's you have symptoms of chronic fatigue, meaning palaging pagod, okay, then you suspect hypothyroidism. So these are alert symptoms for hyper and hypo. So upon neck self-examination plus the feeling of the goiter symptomatology, you say you have a goiter if your thyroid gland is enlarged, number one, your thyroid contains nodules, number two, there is a palpable neck node, which is part of the thyroid, which can be part of a thyroid cancer. There are symptoms suggestive of hyperthyroidism. There are symptoms suggestive of hypothyroidism. So if you have any one of these present, then you say you have a goiter, and then the next step to determine to do is to look for a thyroid specialist, then who will examine you and to check your findings. And then if there's a need for lab test, then a lab test will be done. So another situation in which you can say that you have goiter when the physician examines your neck for whatever reason, the same findings then. Okay, so ito ang doktor na examine. Kung na-examine ng doktor na malaki ang leg ng thyroid mo at it contains nodules, there's a neck node, there are symptoms, then he will say most likely you have a goiter. So another situation, nagawa kasi kadalasan ginagawa yung mga lab tests without consulting a doctor, a specialist, nagagawa na. So this is a situation in which meron na kayong dalang lab test, no? Like, so thyroid function tests are the usual tests being done, FT4, FT3, and TSH, and thyroid ultrasound. These are commonly done. Okay. So dun sa thyroid function test, ang purpose nito is to determine whether you have abnormalities of functions, hyper or hypo. Kung sa ultrasound naman, ang tinitingnan dito, whether enlarged, diffusely enlarged in thyroid gland mo, which may suggest na hyper or hypo, or if there are bucal, no, then you talk about, you consider cancer or not cancer. So yan ang differentiation between the two categories of tests, thyroid function test and ultrasound. Ultrasound is more for to study the structure of the thyroid gland. Thyroid function test to study the functions of the thyroid gland. So what's the next step after you've discovered that you have a goiter in your monthly self-examination? You see a thyroid specialist right away. So do not jump go to the lab, yung mga lab na tumatanggap ng request without a doctor's prescription. Okay. So a thyroid, when you say thyroid specialist in the Philippines, it can be an endocrinologist, general surgeon, or a head and neck ENT, ear, nose, and throat specialist. So the reminder here is do not have the test done without seeing a thyroid specialist first who will examine and palpate your neck to verify your findings. So if the test might, after examinations for thyroid gland by the specialist, the test might not be needed after all. So this thyroid specialist will make a diagnosis based on physical examination and the symptom data. Then he will make the recommendation on what to do next. So you would expect the following. So he or she will explain the findings and diagnosis and then will allay your fear and anxiety, especially if it's benign, nothing to worry, or it's negative, no? Or if it's cancer, baka yung masamang cancer, baka sabihin sa'yo. Then he will answer all your questions and then there'll be an informed consent obtained for the decided treatment. So depending on the diagnosis, the following recommendations will ensue. Number one, pwede i-observe lang and do further self-monitoring and also monitoring by the specialist. Or after that, the other options will be to do diagnostic tests, okay, or bigyan ka ng gamot, like mga medications for hypo or hyperthyroidism, or he might suggest an operation, especially if it's you're dealing with a thyroid cancer. So these are the options that might happen after a diagnosis by the specialist. So when there is a need to be certain if there is hyper or hypothyroidism, sabi natin, hindi tayo sigurado, hindi sigurado yung mga doktor kung hyper or hypo, then if FT4 and FT-TSH are requested. But when there is a need to be certain if the nodule is malignant or not malignant, cancer or not cancer, options may include ultrasound, pwedeng ultrasound muna, and needle aspiration biopsy. These are the two most commonly done lab tests. At times, kung kuminsan may mga doctor gusto mong paggawa ng CT scan, MRI, PET scan, and other tests may be needed. So you just have to ask them why, kasi medyo mahal ito. No? No abnormality. So ito the other question, balik ta rin na natin kanina. When do you need lab tests? Ngayon naman, when do you not have to do lab tests for the thyroid? If there is no abnormality, okay, found on the thyroid on self-examination by a patient and then confirmed by the physical examination by a physician. So you don't need to have the lab test. Sinabi ng doctor, ay wala yan, normal yan. Okay? So the other situation is that the physician is quite certain there is no goiter during the clinical examination. So it doesn't mean that all patients will have to undergo lab tests after a physician examination. So do you need screening lab tests for thyroid? I added this question because a lot of lay people are doing mga, because of the executive checkup na mga packages, they do a lot of lab tests like FT4, TSH, na, and ultrasound. So screening lab test means those lab tests, example, FT4, TSH, ultrasound, other tests done just to check if a goiter is present or not, even when there is no abnormality found in the thyroid on self-examination and physical examination by a physician. So despite na normal ang findings, wala namang nakita yung pasyente, walang nakita yung doktor, pinapagawa pa, no? So screening lab tests are considered not to be cost-effective in the general population except in those with high risk for goiter, but which are very few naman, if not rare in incidence. So pwedeng, so kapa mo na by yourself, by the doctor, kung normal naman, you don't need to have lab tests, screening tests. A common scenario in the community, as I say, which as I told you earlier, this is a no-no. Okay. Ito yung mga palaging madalas ko naririnig. I feel I have a goiter. Mga sinasabi ng mga pasyente po sa akin, parang may goiter ako. Okay. For whatever reason, because sinabi ng neighbor ko, friends ko, na meron akong goiter, and then I have tightness of the neck. Okay. So ang feeling niya, meron. So, then another scenario is that I will have an ultrasound of the thyroid and thyroid function test done even when I have not consulted a physician, or I will request my physician to give me a prescription for this test even if he has not seen me. So ito yung pinaka two common scenarios in the community which I want to caution you on. So no, because the physician needs to do clinical examination first. Then he, she decides when lab tests are needed or not. So beware if you do, itong mga test can be double-edged, minsan may information that you can get, no? But it can also have side effect, negative effect, because there are a lot of false negatives and false positives in the lab, maraming false readings, errors, no? So which will just create anxiety and then more harm and more problem. More harm because you have may konting mali, so you may have to pursue, do more laboratory tests. So I think that's the last slide for this lecture. So I have discussed the following. What is the thyroid gland? Where is the thyroid gland located? Anatomy, diseases that may occur in the thyroid gland. Lab tests for the thyroid gland, what are they? Do you need lab tests? When do you not have to do lab tests? Takeaway in relation to patient empowerment, be always in touch with reliable medical information on thyroid. When do you need lab tests? Knowledge is power. It gives power. Use the 4 Ks of patient empowerment. Kalaman, kakayanan, karapatan, kapangyarihan to gain greater control over decisions and make the better decisions on thyroid. When do you not need lab tests as part of your health management? This ends my pep talk today. Thyroid, when do you need lab tests? I hope I have empowered you to have an essential understanding on thyroid, when do you need lab tests as part of your health management. Let's before we go to the QA, let's reminder, please take the Olete. The link has been placed in the chat box. And then 25 Oletes certificates will entitle one mentee to a voucher for a RO Hoson medical consultation, either face-to-face or telemedical. Then please type in your feedback in the chat box before we adjourn, okay, during the open forum. Then let's now have a group picture taking before we start the QA and interactions. Okay, everybody on board. 1, 2, 3. Okay. The floor is now open for questions, comments, suggestions, sharing of experiences, and even consultation, short consultations. No? Anybody? We'll take a crack first. Tama ba yung sinasabi ko, maraming nagpapagawa ng lab test left and right? Tama ba? Anong naririnig ninyo? Hinihingi ng mga pasyente o yung mga doktor, gawa ng gawa lang kahit na hindi naman talaga kailangan. Na? Okay. Yeah, Susan, you're raising your hands. Unmute.
Sorry. Okay. For a while, 10 years after my thyroid cancer, and because my doctor then was very busy, there was no more examination, no more tests, no? And then eventually, I realized that I have to go back to an endocrinologist. Now that I have an endocrinologist, for the second time, she required me to undergo TSH, what's the other one? Yung blood tests.
FT4.
May mga ganun. I think to determine the dosage of thiodine.
Yeah.
He's going to give me. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Correct me. Okay. So far, yun lang naman. But you were telling us earlier that there are other symptoms, like we feel tired. What else? We're losing weight. I think that is what I experienced before. That's what I experienced before. I was felt tired. I was losing weight. That's why I had to go to a doctor, and of course he palpated, and then I underwent exam, and then the last was an ultrasound. And then eventually, I went under the knife. He removed two of my thyroid glands. Wala bang effect yun na two of my thyroid glands are no longer existing in my body?
Kung walang replacement, may effect. Hypothyroid ka na. So you need thyroid replacement. No?
Replacement is when I take Thiodine. Is that it?
Yeah.
Replacement is when I take Thiodine.
Yeah. Thiodine is a type of thyroid hormones, levothyroxine, which is to replace or to, kasi wala ka ng thyroid hormones, yeah, i-replace niya. No? Ganon. So, so it's just a matter of trying to determine what will be the right dosage for you. Diba? Kaya may serial examination of your thyroid function test like TSH and FT4. No? So if you have to do that, monitoring of the adequacy of your Thiodine is what you're taking. No? So you just have to do yung FT3 FT4, FT4 and TSH will be enough. Sometimes they just use the TSH, no? Okay.
Yeah.
Just TSH, no? Especially in, when kung i-determine lang yung ano, yung level of thyroid hormones that you have to take. But personally, I don't think you have to do it very often. Kahit na once a year, pwede na, no?
Pwede na, no? Dok, ano yung thyroglobulin?
Thyroglobulin is a year test also to check yung ano, usually used to check to monitor yung mga patients with cancer, no? Okay. So kung pag after total thyroidectomy kasi dapat wala nang thyroglobulin, no?
Okay.
Ngayon, kung
Wala
may
naman dito.
thyroglobulin, no? Then it means baka nagre-recur yung thyroid cancer mo, no? So when was the last time you had thyroglobulin?
Matagal na rin. Mga 10 years ago.
So, hindi na inulit.
Hindi na.
Okay.
Oh.
So, but this is done by another, because you shifted to another endo.
Yeah.
Okay. So, iba yung ano, iba-ibang mindset ng ibang doktor, no? Yung iba, because once you have thyroid cancer, they do thyroglobulin. Ako, I don't usually do thyroglobulin. I just monitor it by physical examinations and by symptoms lang. Kasi kung minsan
Okay.
mahirap din i-interpret kung minsan yung thyroglobulin niya. Eh, no? Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome. Any other questions? So yung kay Susan, so you're on the right track. So you need the test. When do you need the test? You need the test to just to monitor your level of thyroid hormones in your blood because you underwent total. But as I said, if you have found the right dosage na, you don't have to do the frequent lab test anymore. No? And then yung thyroglobulin, kasi ilang taon ka na in remission, more than 20 years na ba? Kung more than 20 years na, you don't need your...
Yeah.
Most likely hindi na magre-recur yan. So you just had your neck palpated by a physician, especially a specialist on thyroid cancer. Okay. Then you don't have to do the thyroglobulin anymore. No? Okay. So kinakapa ba ng doktor mo yung leeg mo?
Yeah. Tsaka okay. Ano? Hindi lang. Meron siyang yung dalawang arms ko, pinapa-raise niya ng konti. Tinitignan niya kung, ewan ko, nanginginig o something. Is that part of it?
Ay, arms?
Yeah.
Parang to see if there are tremors.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
May ginaganon.
Okay.
May ginaganon.
Usually, hindi na kailangan yon unless talagang... you're not hyperthyroid. Pag yung mga tremors, hyperthyroid. You're not hyperthyroid. Ha? So, kasi total thyroidectomy, kaya nga kung tinotal ka, kulang naman, hypothyroid ka.
Hypo.
Pero kung sinususpect niya, let's say you're given high dose of thiodine, baka mag-induce ng hyperthyroid. Pero if you're taking 100
100 only. Oh. 100
lang, usually hindi ka it will not produce tremors of hyperthyroidism usually.
Okay.
Anyway, libre naman yan. Oh, huwag ka na matapag. Yeah, pinapataas lang yung kamay mo. Pero it's not necessary. Okay? Good.
Yes, thank you.
That's an illustration of the topic that we presented this afternoon. Okay. So anybody else who want to share the experience that will...
Doctor, may itatanong po ako.
Oh, sige.
How true na, kasi sabi nila, once na nagkasakit ka dun sa matres, may tendency na chances are magkakaroon ka rin sa breast, thyroid, kasi dugtong-dugtong daw po yan. Totoo po ba yun?
In some instances, pwedeng totoo, but it's not very common, no? Kasi parang kasi tingnan mo, yung matres is hormones induced, yung mga ano, di ba? Yung breast hormones induced
Opo.
din yan, no? Thyroid is also part of hormones, no? So, misa, baka may interrelated silang tatlo, no? Pero bihirang bihira, bihirang bihira, no? Okay. So, you just be on the lookout, no? And then use this, your symptoms na lang. Symptoms directed surveillance, no? Ganon. Okay. So,
Kasi ako kasi, I was operated with A, at saka din thyroidectomy.
Maraming ganon.
So, parang kumbaga, parang totoo nga yun kasi parang nagkadugtong.
Hindi dahil not hindi naman siya connect, I mean, hindi naman in a way that it's a cause of the other one, ganun ganun, no? It just so happened that kasi yung mga babae, yung pinaka marami kayong sakit diyan eh, no? Na thyroid, no? Maraming may thyroid sa babae, tama?
Opo.
Maraming sakit sa breast lalo na yung sa lalaki.
Opo.
Wala naman masyadong breast, pero very rare, pero yung lalaki pwedeng karoon ng breast problem din, breast cancer, no? Okay, pero bihirang bihira, no? So, but it's very
Opo.
common in women sa breast, and of course uterus is also another, ano, uterus, ovary, no? So itong tatlong areas nito, no, common sa mga babae, no? Kaya should I say that I pity you women? Okay. Pero kami lalaki naman, prostate ang kalaban namin, no? Ganon. Okay.
Di ba, meron din bang babae nagkaka-prostate?
Hindi, kami,
Wala.
okay, yung lalaki, prostate.
Lalaki lang, doktor.
Lalaki.
Ah, hernia pala yun, yung sinasabi ko. Hernia, di ba?
Hernia.
Meron din babae?
Hernia, mas common sa lalaki kaysa sa babae. Okay.
Opo.
Okay.
Opo.
Okay.
Kasi parang, yun nga, sabi nila, pag na-opera ka daw sa matris, baka most likely, baka maano pa rin sa goiter o kaya sa breast.
It's
Pero hindi
possible.
naman.
It's possible kasi it's possible just by statistics lang kasi very common yung sakit ng tatlong area na yan sa mga babae. Kaya kung nangyayari yan, marami din pasyente na operahan sa gallbladder din. Marami din sa gallbladder, di ba? Sa babae.
Okay.
So, sino? Ewan ko. Baka si, because of, baka kasalanan ni Eva. Kaya. Kaya dami yung sakit.
Daming sakit.
Oh.
Ayun lang po yun, doktor.
Ah, sige.
Nabasa ko kasi.
Any other questions? Sinong may thyroid pa? Okay. Jeng, ano ba yung ginagawa ko sa'yo?
Ano, monitoring pa rin po
Monitoring.
Do.
Monitoring lang, no?
Wala ka ito pa, napaisip talaga ako sa sinabi ni Ate Perla. Kasi may breast, nagkaroon ako sa breast din. Ngayon naman may may goiter.
Yun na eh, di ba?
Ako
naman dito sa uterus. O, napunta rin sa goiter.
Ah, kaya.
Hindi siya.
Siguro nga po yung hormones po. Lalo na pag nagkakaedad na ano po, nagbabago na.
Oo. So wala ka pang uterus problem? Wala pa?
Naku nga na.
Nanawala. Okay. So sino pang may mga thyroid problem? Si Belet. Belet, kumusta ka na Belet? May thyroid yun.
Meron ho. Pero hindi ko pa napapagawa yung ano, yung laboratory.
Okay. So yung laboratory ginagawa, okay, in relation to the topic now, when do you need, ginagawa natin to monitor, di ba? Monitoring, no? Okay, that's another indications for doing the lab test, which I did not expound in this lecture. So we do that to monitor yung mga gamutan, no? Okay. So any more? Huwag kayo basta-basta magpapa ano at alam ba niyo kung magkano yung mga thyroid function tests, alam ba niyo kung magkano?
Mga ano, doktor, 800 plus, parang ganun. TSH 800 plus. Depende sa hospital, doktor. Depende kung mga hospital na, di ba, sa Maddox, mahal doon.
Magkano sa Maddox?
Parang 1,000 plus yata doon. 1 plus. TSH.
TSH? Okay.
Opo.
So, wag kayo, kung magpapalab test kayo, may magagalit sa akin, paggawa na lang kayo sa labas. Mag sa hospital. Yung sarili sa...
I petition.
Sa, yung sa
high precision, mas mura-mura.
500 lang po.
Actually, naitanong ko ng last week, 2 weeks ago, yung sa mga big hospitals, usually maabot ng 2,000 for
opo
each
nga,
test.
2,000
for
ng
each test. T3, T4. So kung tatlo siya, 6,000 na yun, 6,000 plus. Di ba? Yung sa dun sa yung sa mga outside, I won't mention the name, no? Okay. Mga usually 1,000, baka 700 lang, 700 or 600 times 3, mga 2,000 lang kung tatlo, no? Okay. So compared to 2,000 per test to 700 or 600 per test, no? Okay.
Oo, mahal sa ano kasi ang laboratory doon sa Maddox, 300 plus. Sa high precision, mga 100 plus lang.
Which one?
Doktor, yung mga FBS, CREA, SDOT, SDPT.
Okay. Ibang test. Okay.
Oh, mahal po doon sa ano sa mga ospital na ano.
Kaya as a rule, mahal talaga sa loob ng hospital. Kung if you
okay.
can avoid it, no, gawa na lang kayo sa labas, no? Let the doctor do the interpretation, no? So, wag kayo okay lang yung gumawa yung ginagawa ng laboratory sa labas, no? Basta you just have to choose yung mga ISO certified, no? Okay. Na laboratory, no, more or less pwede na yon, no? Then let your doctor decide, interpret the results, no? Now, in relation to our topic also today, okay, I don't think I mentioned it. Kung gagawa kayo ng mga thyroid function test, pwede na yung dalawa lang muna. Okay? You can start with, you can FT4 and TSH. No? Okay. So, kung may mga doctor mag-order sa iyo ng FT3, tanong mo na lang, Doc, pwede bang dalawa na lang? No? Kasi nagiging habit yung mga doktor eh. They just order FT3, FT4, TSH. Na? Okay. So, and since usually wala namang, baka wala namang package, wala namang package yun eh. No? So, by it, yung cost noon, by its test, sa isa. No? So, kung 2,000 isang test, no? 2,000 isang test, so times 3 yun, so, 6,000. Di ba? So kung dalawang test nang gagawin mo, yung mga 4,000, no? Ganon. Makakatipid pa kayo, no? Okay. Kung sa labas naman, baka kung 800 lang, 800, 600, so 1,200 lang. Wala na yung FT3, no? Okay. You just do the FT3 kung kailangan lang, no? Okay. Okay. Any more questions? Sinong who wants to share thyroid? Wala na? Wala nang may thyroid? I don't see anybody with a thyroid. Ellen naman, walang thyroid, no? Ellen, wala kang may thyroid, di ba?
Dok, ako noon ay nag-take din ako noon ng L-troxine.
Uh-huh.
And then there was a time na nagpa-check up ako sa iyo noon.
Uh-huh.
Sabi mo, kung wala ka namang tinatanong mo ako no kung may nararamdaman ako, kung there's something wrong with me, kung may nararamdaman akong pain or whatsoever. Sabi ko, wala. And then sabi mo, eh kung wala naman, eh di, ibig sabihin, kung nagtitake ka ng gamot, may sakit ka.
Okay.
kung wala naman, sabi mo no, kung wala naman, eh di, better na stop it. So, in-stop ko na do, since then.
Okay. Oo, tama ba? Tama ba yung sinasabi?
Oo, wala naman akong ano, wala naman akong naramdaman after.
Hindi, pag yung sinasabi ko, my philosophy is, kung umiinom ko yung kamot, may problema, di ba?
Oo nga, Dok. Tama naman.
Wala naman kayong problema. Bakit kayo iinom yung kamot? Di ba?
Kaya, Dok, hindi na ako uminom.
Oo. Unless talagang may diagnosis ka ng may sakit na kailangan mo ng kamot. Diba?
Eh, noon naman kinapa mo, sabi mo, wala namang, kumbaga, wala naman itong nakapa. Tapos sabi mo it's just an ordinary ano yung thyroid ano hindi naman ganoon.
Okay. So depende sa doctor din 'yon, na yung mindset.
Oo nga, so kasi before nung hindi pa ako nagko-consult sa iyo noon, ang tagal kong nag-take ng eltroxine.
Okay.
Sa bagay, no naman kasi libre yung gamot namin kasi nag-work ako noon sa pharma company. So
gaano katagal na wala ka ng eltroxine?
Ay, matagal na, Doc. Siguro baka hindi lang, more than 10 years.
Okay. So tama ang decision natin. Tama.
Yes, Doc. Yes, Doc.
Okay. So only time will tell kung tama ang decision natin. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for sharing. Anybody
Thank
else
you
want to
though.
Share? Gusto ko yung mga nagsishare para may matuto tayo. No? Kung wala na, we'll call it a day. Wala na? Last call?
Wala na.
Okay. So we will ito pang topic next. Baka PET scan. No? I forget. It's a check ko. Ha? We'll talk about PET scan. No? Kasi very common ang PET scan. No? Eh, para mag-guide. Kasi mahal ang PET scan eh. Pero nagiging popular na siya. Ganun talaga sa medical world, no? Pag may mga bagong ano, nagiging popular, ginagawa na lang lahat, no? Okay. So, but yung pinaka-minimum, hindi na ginagawa. Yung mga pwede pa, no? Okay. So, kung wala nang tanong, we will call it a day. We will see each other next week, next Saturday ulit. Na? Okay?
Okay. Okay, Doc.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, Doc. Happy weekend.
Thank you, Doc.
Ate Perla.
Hi. Hi, Jane.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, Doc. Thank you.
Welcome. Bye-bye.